We're going to visit perhaps one site that we have visited before, but we have new information concerning it, and then we have some new sites. I want to talk for a moment about pre-Columbian history. It is really sad that in our history books, the very books that your children and mine learn from in this nation, teach that Columbus was the first European here, that he discovered America, so forth and so forth. And it's absolutely, there is so many documented proofs, scientifically, that have been found in this great nation, as well as this, I should say, this hemisphere, because it happens from the very tip and the furthest little tip of South America all the way up through to the North Pole, that people have been here. And we certainly know that Europeans were here. Example, Doc Noss's gold mine, the oldest mine claim, at least that I know of in America, around 800 AD, with Celtic Ogham writings, that one as beautiful a panel as you'll ever want to find. And at Waco Tank, south of there, to find a bilingual drawing, that is to say, the word water in two different alphabets, two different peoples. And when you, that's like finding a second witness. Now, you're going to see in this documentary if three different languages used on the same hilltop describing Baal worship, as well as one describing the worship of Christ, or there would be two of those. So we see double witnesses in both respects. And I know some Christians might say, well, why do you bring out that there were Baal worshipers here? Because we're hunters of truth. If they were here, it needs to be documented. Don't ever be afraid of the truth. As we have studied in the book of Jeremiah, has God not stated that what made him angry was for people to worship Baal? Well, they traveled here worshiping still that same Baal. It wasn't only Baal worship in the Middle East that made God angry. There were Baal worshipers here, and you will find those Baal symbols almost any place you will Christian symbols. Why? There's nothing new under the sun. You have Christian people and you have non-Christian people. So never let that distract you or draw you away from a quest to find the truth. If they were here, let's document it. And it as well documents the Word of God, the fact that there were Baal worshipers, that's mentioned many, 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 many times. And it made our Father very angry. So what I'm saying, you're not distracting from the Word of God ever with truth and fact. So that's one of the reasons I know you're going to enjoy this documentary, and we'll get into it here in just a moment, because of these second witnesses, the fact that you will have the Baal symbol in more than one language, such as Ogham, as well as Iberian, and other languages on the same hilltop. I will say one thing. You're going to find some Ogham, and talk about a hard trip up to it. The fellow said it's only 3/4 of a mile from transportation where we'll carry our cameras, but it's straight up, right straight up a creek bank, and it was wet and the water was running. But I know you're going to enjoy it. An old priest certainly had a fantastic place tucked away. And to hear the water come from this little fall, you could tell why he would say he could hear music there, because the waterfall was such that it almost played melodies. And if you were lonesome and if you were down, it would certainly be an exciting, beautiful place to have been. you're going to see a very interesting Olgam panel at this location. From this little fall, you could tell why he would say he could hear music there, because the waterfall was such that it almost played melodies. And if you were lonesome and if you were down, it would certainly be an exciting, beautiful place to have been. You're going to see a very interesting Olgam panel at this location, left there by what some believe to be a hermit priest. Yes, we know there were Levitical priests from the Bat Creek stone that would have been found not too many miles from the area you're going to see here in Clay County, Kentucky. Clay County, Kentucky is an interesting place to me because my own relatives, kin, came through that area many, many years ago, and part of our families passing through there and living in this very area, it always makes one pause and hesitate as you look at the mountains and the hills, the valleys, the cuts, that your great-great-great ancestors, grandparents, could have passed through this very same hill. In my particular case, I know they did pass through this particular county. So it is wonderful to visit these places and to know that our immediate ancestors were late comers compared to some of the travelers that were in this area even before Christ walked the earth, many of them. We have found those signs on other documentaries. So it's always good to move out into our hemisphere, to read the rocks, to read the signs, to read the stones, for messages are there. And it lets us know a great deal more. Number one, that our Father's word is true. He said he was going to scatter them. He indeed did. And there is the proof where we find all these various languages, Greek, Olgam, Iberian, and ancient Hebrew. All these writings will have been covered through this documentary. So, with that thought in mind, back to that beautiful state of Kentucky, the county of Clay, Clay County, Kentucky. Sit back, watch, I know you'll enjoy it. Ladies and gentlemen, here we are in good old Clay County, Kentucky, one more time. And we're here with Jim, and we're sitting upon probably one of the most precious stones as far as ancient writings are concerned in America. Jim, thank you very much for having us back again.
You're real pleased to have you back.
Great. It's our pleasure. Tell us a little bit about this stone before we show them the stone here.
Well, this stone was traced and sent to Dr. Fail by Dr. John Payne from Brea. Mm-hmm. And he translated this, and it's in the Gaelic tongue written in Ogham.
Gaelic tongue in Ogham.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And according to his article in America BC, he quotes Lord Kenneth Clark. Mm-hmm. And he says, the monks of Ireland in the Dark Ages were the repository of learning while Europe lay shattered by the barbarian invaders. And in their stone cells in remote island hermitages, these devoted servants of God somehow continued to keep the oil burning in the very few fragile lamps that survived the collapse of the Western Roman Empire. For four centuries, they alone preserved the learning of the ancients. So we are indeed in a very sacred spot. Here was a man who was a Christian, and he was a learned man, and in a world of darkness where knowledge and understanding had almost disappeared, they were the recipients and guardians of truth.
Well, that's fantastic. It would remind us of, like, we know we had the priest in Loudoun County, Tennessee, which isn't that almost due south of here? It seems
due
you
south.
Told me that way once, yes.
Yeah.
So you appreciate the sound you hear in our background. I'm going to have the camera do a little pan, and you're just fine right there. You'll see where that sound's coming from. I want you to appreciate the setting this priest had, and this is a natural shelter behind us. And he had a rock wall built up around this precious stone that we're about to show you here. Jim, it's real good to be back in Kentucky.
You
thank
know
you
how
for having
we
us.
We are to have you here.
Well, thank you very much.